Color correction or color grading can be used with awesome results for certain shots in clear, sunny conditions. For example, Ikelite ambassador Brandon Verdura gets great results freediving in Hawaii, as does ambassador Karen Bagley shooting maternity portraits in her backyard pool studio. However, there are some situations where sunlight won't reach and an external light is necessary. These include to stop motion when shooting fast-moving subjects, to light small creatures and macro subjects, as fill lights when shooting inside of a cave or shipwreck, as a primary light source when shooting at night, to compensate for lack of sunlight below 40 feet or 12 meters. Wait, why do we need strobes on a clear, sunny day? Even on a sunny day, it gets dark very quickly as you descend underwater. The water gives an appearance like a thick fog, with most of the light being absorbed within just a few feet. Colors fade out and clarity diminishes. Reds, oranges, and purples are almost completely gone by 30 feet or 9 meters. By 60 feet or 18 meters, all you're seeing is blue and a little green. I'm sure you've seen underwater photos that are all blue-green. Color correction in Photoshop or Lightroom can only take you so far. If there isn't enough light in the image, there will be no color to bring back with those sliders. Strobes boost the missing wavelengths of color. This makes reds, oranges, and purples visible at any depth. This concept is difficult to picture. We are totally immersed in this colorless environment while we dive. Our minds actually fill in the colors for you. If you shine a flashlight across the soft and hard corals, you will probably be amazed at the variety of color that you never knew was missing. Let's talk about how to choose a strobe. People get very concerned about what camera model they are shooting underwater. I see people doing so much research on specifications, pixels, frame rates, on and on. Then they choose a strobe based on an arbitrary number like size or weight. In reality, two things make the difference in awesome underwater photos: lens and light. A smaller, cheaper camera with better lenses and brighter lights will outshine the most expensive camera available. There are three things I look for in a strobe, and that's quality of light, beam pattern, and speed. Quality of light is particularly important in wide angle. To get the best contrast of blue water and bright corals, you need a strobe with a warmer color temperature that is daylight balanced. That means you should look for a strobe with color temperature in the 4500 to 5000 degree Kelvin range. Beam pattern is also very important in wide angle. Your strobe should be wide, bright, and very soft. The flash tube is like the light bulb in front of the strobe. A circular flash tube will give you a naturally wide and soft beam. A straight flash tube can be fairly wide, but you'll need a diffuser for it to be soft. Diffusers change the beam and also reduce the power of the strobe at the same time. For some images underwater, speed is critical. Strobes with a rechargeable battery pack will be faster than strobes that use AA batteries. Typically, strobes with rechargeable battery packs carry less risk of flooding in the battery compartment, which can leave you in the dark on your trip. In the end, any strobe is more powerful than no strobe at all. It is possible to take wonderful underwater photos with just one strobe, especially when shooting macro. You can also mix strobes of different intensities and use shadow play to add depth to your photos. What other questions do you have about using strobes underwater? Leave us a comment below. Need a strobe recommendation? Email us via ikelite@ikelite.com with what camera you're shooting, and we'll give you the right choices at any budget. And also be sure to like and subscribe to our channel, and also click the link below to add your email address and subscribe to our weekly newsletter. Thanks for watching. See you soon. Happy diving.